Alright, so earlier today I was rocking the MONSPEET, you know, MONSPEET commandment team, whatever you want to call it, MONSPEET Cure Burst team. And I faced up a guy, or I faced against the, some guy who was rocking this team. And just to be clear, this is what I was using. I was using this, and then I had Athena in the sub. I was using CC food, so I went first, and I kid you not, he absolutely destroyed me. I don't know how. You know, I went first, I targeted his kill, we almost killed kill, and then, yeah man, somehow, with, I'm pretty sure he was using attack food, because he was hitting me like a truck. When I tell you, his MONSPEET was doing so much more damage than mine, his kill was doing more damage than mine. I just had to assume he's using, he was using attack food, right? His molascular was hitting me like a truck, so let's try this out. He did have Zildjus in the back. Let's see how is this the best version to run the MONSPEET team? I don't know, man, because I was running the MONSPEET team. I went first. I thought, yeah, easy win, and we got absolutely destroyed. I'm not even kidding. You know, blue molascular, almost impossible to kill without an ultimate, because the lifesteal was just too, you know, it's just too great, too high, you know. So let's see how we do. We have the glue eater team here now. I don't want it. If only that was a level 1, man. If only that was a level 1. Because now this probably means we'll kill her with just these two skills and she'll have a lot of HP left. Let's try this. I mean, she's gonna die turn 1 regardless, but I just... Yeah, big damage. Actually, perfect decision. Very, very good. Now, she's gonna revive with, you know, nothing left, and then we can easily deal with her. So, yeah. GG no re, the game is already done. When you're able to kill their green their goddess Liz that fast, there's just nothing they can do. With MONSPEET commandment, they can't just rush their ultimate silly nilly. So yeah man, GG's. GG's boys. Alright. What do we want to do here? What do we want to do? I think we can just make this play right here. Yeah. Kill the Elizabeth. Get some extra chip damage on the Lost Vein. And the Lost Vein is going to die here as well, I think. Alright. So close, but yet so far. This is why I need to buy a MONSPEET's final UR weapon. I still haven't bought the last UR weapon, man. I really would, but... Considering that turn one, my MONSPEET can basically put Elizabeth so low that we just take off her revive, I really don't feel like I need to buy the weapon, man. Obviously, if the Lost Vein explodes on MONSPEET, there's nothing you can do. You're just gonna have to, you know, take it on the chin. Nothing you can do about it. He's gonna die. He's green. Lost Vein is red. He's just gonna take a poo on his chest. So unfortunate. However. We kill the Lost Vein 100% with those two skills, and then Molascula can do some big PP damage to the King. Look at her go. She might just kill King as well, you know. Blue Molascula in the commandment team is very, very powerful. Do not underestimate her. And yeah, almost. good enough. That's what I'm trying to say. Good enough from our favorite waifu. Alright, well that was unfortunate, but it's fine. Everything is a-okay. Because now we can... Is this the best way to maximize our damage? I think it is, yeah. That's the best way to make do with what we got. Oh yeah, definitely. I guess Molascular AoE could have killed King and done some damage to Merlin as well, but you know, who cares? We don't care about min-maxing, because we're gonna win anyway. I'm telling you, the MONSPEET team is becoming incredibly powerful and pretty, you know, it's pretty used, man. You could almost say it. I don't want to say it's like meta, but it's counter meta, you know. Everyone's using it. Well, not everyone, but you know, the people who are using it, they're using it with the intention of countering the Goddess Liz Glue Eater team. So yeah, let's keep going. Don't be surprised if we find some MONSPEET teams ourselves, because people are running them, trust me. People are running this team. However, We have Malascula. And Blue Malascula is the trump card in this team. Trust me. She is slept on so hard when she is such a good unit that, you know, when people see her, they kind of just like, oh, he's using Malascula. Must be a simp. But like, when they see what she can do to their units, man, trust me, they change their mind quick. And we just got a guaranteed kill on his kill. Feels bad. That's why you have MONSPEET on the left. If you open up something like this, that's just guaranteed death on one unit, man. There we go. Two shot, bro. Two shot with type disadvantage. Type disadvantage. Not gonna lie, I wasn't the biggest fan of MONSPEET, right? The green one. Until Kyo came out. Now he's insane. Now he's incredibly powerful. So very powerful. Before, I didn't like the fact that, you know, I have to run him with Escanor or some kind of ignite unit and then, you know, use the ignite skill first and then yada yada yada. Now the ignites are applied for you and you can just go to town. Like Malascula is gonna go to town right here. Kill the Lost Vein. Oh yeah. Once again though, I'm disappointed by Champion 1. I faced I faced mostly real players when I was in Champion 2, when I was playing PvP off screen, and then the moment you get into Champion 1, it's just utter silence, bro. Feels bad, but what can you do, man? What can you do? I got petrified. What can we do? We can kill the king. Yeah, I'm very, very certain we kill King here. Almost 100% certain. MONSPEETO! Yeah. Very, very nice. Blue Malascula is a really good compliment here. I mean, I don't think the red one is too good in this team because the red one isn't... I mean, technically she is a better damage dealer, but the reason why we are using the blue is she's blue. That's the entire point, right? We have red, we have green, we also add blue, so that way we can do extra damage to all color types, you know. With Lost Vein Meliodas, we can do extra damage to him with our Malascula. You know, Kyo is gonna destroy green units and even red units. And MONSPEET just doesn't care. You know, he really just doesn't care about what type you are. He's gonna destroy you either way. Like, as you guys saw, didn't we two-shot that Kyo from last game? Level 2 weak point skill and then the level 1 second skill, we two-shot him? That was crazy, man. That was crazy. Alright, what's next? Blue Eater team, yeah? Come on, man, please. Stop screwing me over, game. Where's the real players, man? Every time, MONSPEET's first two skills equals Goddess Liz enters next turn with no HP left. Every time, bro. They can't even counter that. You literally can't even counter that unless you're running Gotha and King and then you rank up King for the heal. You can't counter that, bro. You really can't, and it's pretty damn cancerous. Like, MONSPEET just guarantees the Liz dies on turn 2. What can we do here? Malascula. Yeah, we'll do this. Shield break. Nice. Very nice there from Kyo. Obviously, Red Zeldris, he is in the back doing his thing. There we go. 50% of Lost Vein's HP with a level 2 Malascula attack. Keep in mind, Lost Vein has incredibly high defense and resistance. But Malascula doesn't care because she has incredibly high pierce rate. You know what I'm saying? Oh, don't kill MONSPEET. I have a juicy level 2 here, please. Please. Alright. Malascula kill. MONSPEET do big PP damage. Yeah. Yeah. There we go. Malascula just deals with Lost Vein too easily. 53k level 2 seems legit. Yeah, I'm convinced this is the best way to run MONSPEET. I'm actually convinced, because you know, even before I recorded, I was testing out this team with Molascula, and I was facing alt teams and stuff, but they really get screwed over by MONSPEET's commandment. And because you can pretty much kill a unit every turn with this team thanks to Molascula, it's just like, you know, it's really difficult for the opponent to actually, you know, do anything with their ult gauge. Like, by the time they get their ultimate, that unit's probably dead because we just kill so fast. Like, look, the damage we're doing here is just silly, really. It really is. But if the game would stop screwing me over and give me a role player, otherwise I'm gonna have to re-record this, and I don't want to re-record videos, man. I really don't want to have to re-record videos because the game refuses to give me decent matchmaking. That's a bummer, you know. That really annoys me, you know. And sorry if you can hear some kind of, you know, ASMR or something. I am eating some food, so keep that in mind. All right, here we go. Surely, yeah. Alright, this guy's using CC food, because you can't get 128 with attack food. That is impossible. I wonder who he's going to go for. He's going to go for Kyo. Alright. Oh, he even got a nice crit. Really? Hmm. Okay. Alright, well, you see what he done to our Kyo. Let's see what we do to his Kyo, because we have Molascula, whereas he has Zoldyck in the front. Let's see. And we do have attack food. Show me show me what this team does. There we go. Turn 1, kill Kyo in the mirror match. Now, sure thing, they are gonna kill my Kyo. Oh, this man do be having Escanor in the back. This man do be having Escanor in the back, huh? I see. However, we have Zeldris, and he has 2 greens. So, let's see how we do. It's going to be very difficult for his Escanor to kill my Molascula, because like I said, she has insane lifesteal. But let's see how it goes. Alright. 25k to the face, 17k to the face, noted. Okay, how do we want to do this? Molascula. Let's do this, just so we can get the extra damage. I would have preferred to use it, you know, both skills, but I do want the extra damage from MONSPEET, so we did have to apply the debuff there. Alright. He went first, but yet we have the upper hand so far. Oh, he got a level 3? Nani? Uses the weak point, we take no damage. Molascula survives this. Yeah. She survives. Alright, let's maximize the lifesteal. And you see what I mean, guys? In the mirror match, we're just going to win. Like, we are literally going to win, regardless whether we go first or second, simply because we have Molascula. I kid you not. Like, this is your proof. The mirror match, we went second. You know, there's just nothing else I can say, really. The best way to run MONSPEET is clearly with blue Molascula. There's just no better way to run him. I'm convinced. Athena in the back, yeah, sure, but if you play the team correctly, you're not gonna get ult rushed. Okay. Feels bad, man. Alright, let's apply the debuff there, get some juicy damage on the MONSPEET, and reduce the Escanor gauge. Oh my god, the damage. Shame we don't have an ignite, but the damage, bro. Oh my god, the damage. So it's like, Zoe just walks in with his big PP damage, and it's just a wrap, man. It's just a wrap. Obviously, this game was a bit drawn out. You know, it's gone on for quite a bit of time, but in mirror matches generally do take a bit longer than, you know, different team kind of games. Lots of back and forths and stuff, but we're going to win this turn. It's over. It's over. Also, you see how my Zildjian survived the my MONSPEET survived the entire match despite him starting the game with two red units. You gotta respect MONSPEET, man. Oh, look at me saying that as if I didn't just leave MONSPEET till the end there. But there you go, boys. He has Molascular in his name, yet he does not use Molascular. What kind of failed simp is he? I don't know. I don't know. But good thing we did get a mirror match, and well, I proved to you which team is better. It's the Molascular team. You don't have to take my word for it, but you know, hopefully the video convinces you. Glue eater team. Oh, this is filth. Remember the two card combo. Wait, I think he's gonna kill her here, please. Okay, good. Yeah, the two card combo, man. Well, at least for me, at least, because I'm missing that UR weapon for MONSPEET. She's always gonna be left on nothing, you know? She is always gonna be left with nothing on her HP bar, and then we can just clean her up next turn and not have to worry about her. Alright, let's wrap this up. Let's wrap this game up, man. Blaze AoE, I guess. Kill Escanor while we're at it, I guess. And, yeah. Oof. I should have used another AoE. God damn it. God damn it. But, yeah. No struggles whatsoever. MONSPEET is actually pretty god tier, man. In this team, you know, it's pretty damn god tier. I'll definitely be making my changes to the tier list. Definitely. I'm just gonna risk it for a biscuit here. Let's see if these kill. Okay. All right, MONSPEET, calm down, bro. Calm down. This guy did 70k, two hits, type disadvantage. Oh my Jesus. Alright. Good stuff, MONSPEET. Good stuff, bro. But sayonara. Let's see how much this does. 34. Noted. Alright, 51. But obviously, that's Cold Destruction, you know, tab advantage, all that stuff. Fair enough. Alright, man. How many points did we get from this? 15. Maybe we should have got a bit higher, but oh well, who cares? Everyone we've faced in this game, we've completely sacked. You know, not even close. The MONSPEET team. Well, this one with Molascular, I haven't lost to it. But the one with Athena, I lost to the team, this exact team, the one that has Molascular. So, do you know what I mean, guys? For whatever reason, I can't explain why. Well, I guess I can, because, you know, three different types, three different units who do really good damage. You know, Molascular, hard to kill. She's also bait for green units. They think they can kill her, and then she doesn't die, like you saw with the Escanors. I mean, a very solid team. I think this is the best way to run MONSPEET. I really do. I think with his commandment turned on and how fast we kill units, I really don't think ult teams are a threat. But that's just my opinion, of course. I really don't feel like you need Athena. You can by running Molascular, you get extra stats from Zeldris's passive as well as a very powerful unit. So it's just, I think it's just common sense that this is the best team. But yeah, anyway, guys, that will be it for today's video. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe to my channel if you are new. And I'll see you guys in the next one.